But all the juices.
You don't want to see it.
Yeah.
No, we need that part. Need that
so part. We'll just tape this part. What are we taping here?
I think we should slash this part.
We wanted to design a true karambit type neck knife. Into a slash, into that, the guiding, lethal option. Warning, you use this way, you go to jail, period. Pull down. You have that retention on this particular grip, that you open your hands, you don't lose your blade. In the traditional grip, I open my hands, I don't lose the blade either. So that's one of the nice things about having it. It's small enough to where it's very comfortable to carry. It's long enough you feel comfortable with the extension for a defensive knife or for everyday carry, for utility use, for thrusting and cutting, so that it can puncture on its motion. And here's your delivery. Oh, that's a nasty, nice cut right there. And cut all the way to that there. And into the meat. What he's doing is pretty much going for limb destruction, which is very common in the Filipino martial arts. It's called defanging the snake. He's trying to be merciful simply by poking and just destroying the limbs. And then, of course, by the time it gets to the head, it's probably because the guy just kept on attacking. What Kuya Chris here is doing is extending to puncture. At the same time, he's puncturing on a backhand here, or forehand puncture, or at the same time guiding. Now, any kind of guiding without any lacerations can be used by the curved here of the D-Max. If he wanted to lacerate, he would use the inside curve of the D-Max karambit.
Multiple punctures. But again, this was 15 attackers coming at me.
The perfect student for me is one that is open-minded to learn what I'm teaching, but at the same time is able to communicate what works for them and how I can be a better teacher.